If there were a Mount Rushmore of WGN television personalities,
three balls and the strike. Long drive, way back, it might be, it could be, it is. Holy cow!
Harry Caray's face with his signature oversized glasses,
listen to this crowd,
would be etched in stone along with the other greats.
He was a legend, loved by legends.
But since there's not a Mount Rushmore, a statue outside of the Wrigley Field bleachers showing Harry pointing the WGN sports microphone back at the fans he loved will have to do.
The most popular figure in Cubs history.
A home run! Oh, did he ever cream that tomato!
The boisterous baseball broadcaster's name is synonymous with the Cubs on Channel 9. And with fun itself.
I think the gift of Harry is, here's a guy who was the longtime announcer for the Cubs' most hated rival, the Cardinals.
Way back is Brock, he jumps. Holy cow, did he make the catch or not? Yeah, he's got the ball, the game is over. Lou Brock, a spectacular leap through the air.
Here's a guy who spent 11 years doing their crosstown rival, the White Sox.
Pop fly, shot left, Sox win, Sox win, Sox win, holy cow!
And who's the most beloved announcer the Cubs have ever had? It's Harry.
In 1981, he took over in the Cubs booth for retiring sportscasting giant and baseball Hall of Famer, Jack Brickhouse.
Jack Brickhouse was somehow replaced by somebody who was even bigger than him. He was replaced by Harry Caray.
Jack was really more of a play-by-play, let's do the ball game, have some fun, but the ball game is really the key. Harry is more do the ball game, but let's have a little more fun if we can.
He's a cinch to hit 24 home runs or better, and if the wind is blowing out, he might hit 40.
Caray was entertaining and exciting, funny and friendly.
The quintessential life of the party.
He made an immediate impression on the Cubs faithful, and thought of himself as a stand-in for the fan who couldn't be at the ballpark, a point he made upon his 1989 induction into the Hall of Fame.
He was every man. He was the fan's voice in the booth.
You never knew what was coming out of his mouth, that's for sure. It was probably a little wilder in the beginning. When he got sick, he kind of toned it down a little bit. But still, you never knew. It was so unpredictable.
His legendary nightlife exploits earned him the nickname the Mayor of Rush Street.
You know, with Harry and going out, it's tough to separate the myth from the legend. He embraced both. No matter what he was doing, he wanted you to think he was out all the time.
Man, this man is history. This is the man of Chicago.
But behind the Cub fan, Bud man, party persona, there was a true professional, according to WGN-TV Director of Production, Bob Vorwald.
His motto to those of us who worked behind the scenes were, when the team is bad, we've got to be better. Well, most seasons, that means Harry had to be great because the teams weren't that good.
I really want them to do well. But once I start doing the game, the ball is hit to him. It goes through his leg. How in the world can I say his heir won the ball game?
And it's a testament to Caray that so much forgettable baseball became memorable television.
But he found a way to share that love of baseball every day. The fans knew he was one of them. He was a fan. He was not afraid to call people out. You had to keep watching. You never knew what he would say or do. But his love of the game shone through every pitch, every inning, every game.
I can still see some of those gigantic home runs going over the back wall at Wrigley Field.
He warmly welcomed viewers from around the country to the friendly confines each afternoon with the same three words.
Hello again, everybody.
He stepped into the booth on Addison Street, which is just 2 miles west of the WGN studios, just as WGN could be seen for miles and miles across the country on the new superstation.
People got to know him a lot more around the country.
So I know a lot of people probably were raised on Harry Caray's style of baseball broadcasting.
He was a celebrity in Chicago.
Harry was a great sportscaster, but he achieved this larger-than-life thing because he was across the country on WGN.
And throughout the nation, as perhaps the most well-known and beloved baseball announcer of his day, even inspiring a parody on Saturday Night Live. He suffered a stroke in 1987, leading to a parade of play-by-play pinch hitters in the WGN booth, including Bill Murray.
Run, right field.
Run, Bo. Show us how you can run.
How about that one?
Shaka Ono, bro. Shaka Ono, bro.
And Bill Murray tells a story about how he would go up into the booth and peek into the fridge that Harry Caray kept in the broadcast booth. And for him, it was kind of like discovering that Santa Claus was real.
And this bud's for you, Bill Murray.
He was more than the mayor of Rush Street. I mean, he was the mayor of Chicago, he was the mayor of baseball, he was the mayor of WGN. He just had that gravity. Everybody wanted to be around him and touch him.
Harry Caray is also responsible for a beloved ballpark tradition that echoes far beyond Chicago.
Seventh inning stretch. It involves singing Take Me Out to the Ball Game.
He says, I knew that you were the right guy because anybody sitting in the stands would know immediately that he could sing as well or better than you sing and would freely join in.
It's a tradition that actually began at Comiskey Park. And continued to Wrigley Field.
He would sing the song, the stadium would sing, and I'm sure there were probably people at home singing along.
Well, part of it was the fact that he just opens a window and turns to the fans and talks to you. You know, the seventh inning stretch is great, but it can kind of be kind of like a little, you know, boring little song, but Harry Caray made it a rock song. He wasn't just along for the ride, he was a ringleader.
This is an outstanding crew that brings you Cub baseball every year.
His legacy lives on. He was that shining voice who would say anything. There were no sacred cows with Harry.
But there were plenty of holy cows. which often punctuated his trademark home run call.
When the ball is hit, you know it might be.
There's a drive way back, might be.
You see the left fielder moving back, you know it could be.
Could be!
It lands in the bleachers, it is.
It is! Holy cow!
I didn't let the play finish and then call it, which is the easy way to do it because you never make a mistake. But many's the time I thought it was a home run. I did, it might be, it could be. Whoop, he caught the ball.
You know, I think I fall somewhere in between.
At one point, there were three generations of Careys broadcasting baseball.
Well, Harry Caray is a national landmark. There's no doubt about it. He has defined our business. I don't know if anyone coming along now could ever be as bombastic and as exciting and as controversial and have as much just plain old fun as my father has.
In 1998, just before the start of the baseball season, Harry Caray died of cardiac arrest and brain damage. He was 83. But his spirit never really left Chicago, the Cubs, or WGN. His voice echoes every time they play Take Me Out to the Ball Game at Wrigley Field.
So long, everybody!
A living testament to Harry Caray's monumental legacy.